funny money, persuading the gov. I see our lives in their palms, and it fits like a glove. See our time to evolve, but it just doesn't budge. Use my mind to expose a system of bluff, but through our lives we'll involve.
A video will help us do that, because it's up to you guys, media, to show the rest of the country what the people feel.
A lot of people will sit home and say, I don't want to get involved. Do you feel that when they see something like this down at their own grassroots level, this will encourage them to step out and join?
Yes, I think when they see the mass building, and you know, you get that critical mass, and then people start to realize, hey, there really is something to this movement. There really is problems out there that we have to take care of. So it's going to just go. Things are going to go better. You watch. The corporations are going to pay attention.
We're the ones who can see.
You hearing me at all? Now wake up now. Take a look around you. And this is what's going down. Wake up now. Take a look around you. And this is what is going down.
It's awesome. And here I am in my 60s and just absolutely delighted at the power of the younger people who are taking up this cause. Like we who are belong to the older generation are just so proud of you and so grateful to you for doing what you do. Absolutely. Thank you. And James Gordon wrote a song called We Owe It to the Pioneers to Take This Country Back.
If they saw their squandered legacy, they would surely be ashamed. All they worked for, all those years for, we have given it all away. To the bankers and the bureaucrats and to the Conrad Blacks, we owe it to the pioneers to take this country back. To the miners in Cape Breton, toiling deep beneath the ground, who never even made enough to buy the coal that they found. To the Dust Bowl farmers starving in their cold tar paper shacks, with to the pioneers to take this country back.
I just really wanted to express my appreciation for everyone showing up. I really feel it's important that we all stand in solidarity and work together to make change here. You know, we're on the brink of something huge, and you know, we can all feel it inside. We see the problems in the world, and that's why we're all here today to, you know, kind of raise awareness and you know, promote some change, to create the changes that we want to make and make it this place a better world. Thank you.
Hey, my name's Jacob. Thanks for coming out. This is awesome. It's good to see everybody coming out for positive change. Everybody's here for different reasons, but I'm going to tell you a couple of the reasons why I'm here today and why I think we need change. To start, Barrie has the highest unemployment rate in all of Canada. Shame, shame, shame. Like 11.7%, and that's what Stats Canada says, so I imagine it's actually a little bit higher than that. They don't include the people who have been out of work for more than a year. They don't include the people whose unemployment benefits have run out. So if you're under 25 years old, unemployment in this city is 26%. 1 in 4 people don't have a job, and the jobs that are being created in this city are part-time, minimum wage, contract, they're crap jobs. We're seeing in this country, we've lost so many jobs in this country, and the government keeps telling us that those jobs are being made back up, but they're not. The jobs that are coming back are part-time, low-wage, unsecure jobs. OPSU just went on strike last month to fight for good jobs for the future for our community. This is what we're struggling against. These are the types of things that we need to pay attention to and fight for, because it's for our future, so we can have a good country, a good community, and a good country for our future and for our children's future. I'm a student myself. We have
to go out and get an education so that we can hopefully get a good job. We come out of our education with $30,000 plus of debt to only find that there's no jobs out there. I know so many people who have gotten their education trying to get a better job and make a better life for their future, and they finish and they get a job at Walmart.
If they're lucky.
If they're lucky. So that's all I'm here to say. I'm so glad that everybody's come out here to support positive change, and they're staying together, united. The people, united, will never be defeated.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Marianne, and I'm actually with the Council of Canadians, and I'm also with Transition Barrie, with Amnesty International, and with Aware Simcoe, who really worked to get a little bit of corruption out of our Simcoe region council. And I would just say, I'm 70 years old, okay? And I think it is shameful that these young people, and I as an old person, and so many older people here, that we have to hand this kind of a word to the young people. I think that is a real shame. And I can say that I didn't wake up to the problems that we're having until about 10, 15 years ago. And our generation there was already the big push to poison us with vaccines, with bad food, all the white bread that people are eating and the brown bread that they call bread, that isn't bread, that makes it impossible for young people to think critically. You wonder why there are so many people at home. They are at home because they have been dumbed down in school. The education that we have nowadays is so shameful. Shame, shame. I can only say that I'm so indignant about the whole thing. But I'm also very aware of the fact that there are a lot of people that are really working on this, and I think the rest of us will just have to go and talk to our neighbors, talk to anybody that you can. There's a lot of talk on the media all the time that Occupy doesn't have a message. The message is that there's so much wrong that the list would be from here to China and back.
Here's there.
So the reason I'm here today, it is true we are facing all these big local issues, but we also have some very massive issues on a global or even national scale, such as, for starters, big money in politics. I think we can all agree that that is a problem when there's four lobbyists per MP on Capitol Hill, or Parliament Hill. That's just wrong. So change does not begin right now, and I know some people may argue with that, but change actually began as soon as you made the choice to participate. That is when change started. So my goal for being here today is to show the broader 99% that could not or are not able to be here what is going on, and try and convince them that yes, they can get involved. You don't have to show up at a march to be involved. Just spreading the word on Facebook or Twitter, talking to your friends, running at your own general assembly in your house with your five best friends. There's so much you can do. So by being here, we are showing that we're not waiting for things to change. By marching, we are displaying our solidarity with the broader Occupy movement. And by having a general assembly, we are being the change we want to see. And that's all I gotta share.